Snoopy the Snooper, that's what they call him.
Here's to Pro.
Cheers.
Cheers. From now on, our chief flute seller. In fact, you've done so well, I think I'm going to give myself a little break.
But you can't stop. Not now. Bob Ross has got a customer. He's looking for a thief. Said there's big money in it.
And I'll help you, Skip. I'll come with you.
No, you won't. Don't be so stupid.
Skippy gave me the kitten, so I'm going to help him with the stealing, and that's that.
I'll do it. Bigger money equals bigger plans. And bigger cakes to buy.
See?
Va bene. My customer will meet the thief lord in the confessional, the back left of the Basilica San Marco. And the Conte likes to shroud himself in mystery.
Is he a real Conte?
Are you deaf? What did I just say? As far as your stupid head is concerned, he is the Conte. Now, is there anything more you need to know?
I need to fly off the handle. What time?
Tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock sharp. And I reserve the right to fly off the handle whenever I feel like it. Thank you very much.
3 o'clock, Backlift Chapel, Basilica, Confessional. Got it. Come on, prop.
Hold on, hedgehog boy. Now, you and your snotty little friend can tag along if you want, but your master has to be there in person. Got it?
But the thief lord won't like that at all.
Won't he? Well, he'll have to live with it. Otherwise, he doesn't get the job.
You here?
Oh, I'm just out and about with my camera. Oh, am I interrupting important detective work again?
Well, I am still on the case.
Oh, how exciting. What sort of case?
Well, I can tell you that it involves kids.
Well, I'm sure they're innocent.
No, no, no. This case isn't about guilt or innocence.
Look, if children are in trouble, it's usually because they've been misled or used by adults. You should lock up the parents. Well, I'm sure I'll be running into you again when you're up to no good. Anyway, drop by and see my new house one of these days. Instead of loitering on San Marco all the time.
Well, it's just that they say everyone crosses...
Ciao!
Never mind.
Prosper, Oscar, you come inside with me and the others wait here.
But I don't want to wait here.
Me neither. Why can't we all go?
Because Scipio said so. Was that not a good enough reason for you?
One should not wear a mask in church any more than a hat.
One should not plan a theft in a confessional either. And that's what we're here for, right?
So, you are the thief lord. Well, keep your mask if you must. I can still see that you are very young.
Yes, and you're very old. Does age matter in this transaction?
Not in the least. So, Signor Barbarossa has surely told you that I am looking for someone to retrieve something for me. Something for which I have searched for many long years.
What about the payment?
I see you are a businessman. Your fee will be 50,000, payable upon delivery.
50,000? Sounds like a fair price.
Come on, little boy, look at me. Look at the silly old fool who's playing Scarecrow. Come on.
Buongiorno.
You will see that what you are to steal is of great value only to me. It is made neither of gold nor of silver, but of wood.
When shall we deliver it to you?
As soon as your skills permit. I am an old man. I have only one wish left in this world, to hold in my hands that which you are to steal for me.
How do I know how to find you?
You will find everything you need in this confessional when I have left. Send me word of your success and you will receive a letter from me the very next day at Barbarossa's.
So, what's your name, kind fellow noble knight?
Boy, what's yours?
Victor.
Victor?
I'm a victim of circumstances. All these rotten pigeons.
Basket? What's inside?
Whatever it is, I think it's alive.
Don't open it. It could be a poisonous snake.
It's a homing pigeon. Don't think it's poisonous.
Hey, you know, I live in a hotel just near the Grand Canal. What about you?
In a cinema.
You live in a cinema? What, so you can watch movies all day long?
No, it's broken, but Mosk is trying to mend it.
Oh. Yeah, what's it called?
Can't remember.
Wouldn't it be nice if you had a proper house to live in? I mean, don't you have any relatives who could take care of you?
There's my Aunt Esther, but she's not nice and she never smiles.
Uh-huh. You're telling me.
Where's Bud?
I've got to go. It was nice talking to you. You take care of yourself.
All right.
Furthermore, the city is alive with tales of magic and enchantment. We're paying close attention to the stories and details, which makes Venice so alluring.
This Victor thing of me, what did he ask you?
He asked me my name.
Did you tell him?
What else did you tell him, Beau?
I'm not sure. Did Aunt Esther send him? But he was friendly.
Beau, how many times do I have to tell you? Do not talk to
strangers. I know. But he was funny.
What was he wearing?
Blue jacket and a red cap.
And his watch had a moon on it.